classic GE locomotives on the Minnesota Commercial. The Minnesota Commercial Railway has long been known for its fleet of Elko locomotives. However, in recent years, General Electric locomotives have started to take the reins from the Elkos and dominate the railroad. In this opening shot here at New Brighton, we see the belt shop heading south with Minnesota Commercial 1983 leading the way. This General Electric B23-7 was built for Conrail back in April of 1979, and to this day retains the number it was built with, 1983. Minnesota is known for its frigid cold winters, we do have the occasional warmer days in February. This can cause some interesting things along the right-of-way, such as pumping of mud when a train goes over a joint, as seen here. After seeing the belt shop depart New Brighton, we will run into it again at County Road C West in Roseville, Minnesota. Trailing behind the 1983 is Minnesota Commercial 2002. This is also a former Conrail B23-7 and was built in August of 1979. As the belt job nears their home yard in St. Paul, we'll watch them cross over Como Avenue Southeast. Back in the day, Twin Cities Rapid Transit ran on this road, and it was the last operating streetcar line before operations ended. We'll see the belt job one last time from Raymond Avenue in St. Paul. The two B23-7s sounded great as they pulled their lengthy and heavy train into the Commercial's home yard. Another notable pair of B23-7s on the Minnesota Commercial are the 44 and 43. Here, they're seen pulling up and getting ready to tie onto their train, which today is the Hugo Job. The Minnesota Commercial's home yard is right next to the BNSF Railway's Midway Sub. Pulling past with four modern General Electric locomotives was the Northtown BRC. Minnesota Commercial 1982 and 2002 from the first part of this video were former Conrail units, these locomotives are both former Santa Fe, and were both built in 1979 as well. If one looks closely at the handrails of these locomotives, you can see Santa Fe paint starting to chip through. after tying onto their train, the B23-7 duo pulls past and waits for the light at St. Anthony. Just north of Park Junction is a great spot to see these locomotives really start to dig in and notch it up. We'll see the Hugo Job one final time in Roseville, Minnesota. This is one of the few spots on the entire Hugo line that still has a station sign standing. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment below what you'd like to see in a future video.